It was hell, I tell you. No.
If I may be allowed to ask, on behalf of Sylvester, you had a wonderful time making the Five-ish Doctors reboot.
Me and never paid us a penny. No, actually, it was great fun. It was a hoot, really. It's a lovely journey we went on. We started in Australia with your handheld camera.
Yeah, my handheld camera.
You know, professional.
Well, it started off, it's going to be about 10 minutes while he heads for life. Yeah. I never use any of that stuff.
Oh, really? Well, that could be the second one.
Yeah, it could be the second one. But yes, when the BBC gave me, well, I sent them the script because I knew I wanted to film down in Cardiff. And as I say, originally it was going to be just me with my hand on the camera. And so I sent them the script, and then I got pulled down to Cardiff, and I thought I was in trouble. But then they gave me £25,000, and I thought this was the most vast amount of money. They said, we'd like to give you £25,000 and the camera crew to help to make this thing. And I thought, this is amazing, £25,000. And so we sat down, we had a meeting. By the end of lunch, the £25,000 was gone. It was quite a lot of money, just in... They said, well, you didn't end up in London. The BBC. I said, well, we can film this here, that's going to cost you about £5,000. We can film this here, that's going to cost about £7,000. And it was just, no money was gone. We had to get back and beg for some more. But it just grew. From 10 minutes to about 35 minutes. And every time we heard of someone who wasn't happy about being in the 50th anniversary special, we just rode them into ours. John Barrowman is the obvious. My daughter rang me up and said, John Barrowman's really cross. He's not in the 50th anniversary special. So I said, well, all right, we've seen it now. So we rang him up. And so Sylvester said, I love that help, but I've got to go back to New Zealand to film The Hobbit. And so I said, well, you know, maybe we could get Peter Jackson. I do a scene about you going back and being there with Peter Jackson. And he said, Sylvester mentioned it to Peter. And then I sent Peter Jackson an email, and he replied 5 minutes later.
Yeah.
I was so impressed with that. And he said, I'd love to do it, and I'm going to get Ian McKellen, Beth McKellen involved as well. I thought, wow, we're really talking business.
Yeah.
So it was great. We had a great day.
It was.
And Sylvester even came back one day early from Paris to film for us.
I missed breakfast in Paris.
Yeah.
Because Paul McGann was so busy doing other things, he could only fit me in.
Yeah. Right,
who is your best doctor? first, not yourself.
He's bigger than me.
I love Patrick Troughton was my doctor growing up.
Same here.
I suppose that he would have been my doctor. Although I thought that David Tennant was all right. But I think because he was my doctor growing up, William Hartnell, I watched for 3 years, loved him, but I think Patrick had the most difficult job because he was the first generation. No one had, I remember when I heard about another actor coming in to play the doctor, I thought, this is awful, it's going to be terrible. And I remember sitting down and watching that first episode of Patrick's and being won over in the space of that first half an hour. So I just thought, a wonderful job. And he plays a very special doctor. Very unlike William Hartnell, and yet absolutely the doctor.
Yeah, he was my first doctor. I hadn't seen William Hartnell. I'm so poor, I don't have a television. And when we did get the television, I had to move out of the shoebox. But anyway,
on the M6.
Yes.
Yeah.
We used to do the football polls, a group of us, and sit down and wait for the results. And then suddenly this funny program came on afterwards, and we became addicted to it. And it was Patrick Troughton, who's my doctor. Yeah.
John Pertwee was my doctor, and I think you should. but he was the doctor I grew up with, and so he's my doctor.
Yeah.
Who's your doctor? Who's your favourite doctor?
I was going to give you the name of his GP now.
David Tennant.
Well, there you go. No, that's good. I'm with that English accent. I got a phone call when he was off in the car from Scotland, newspaper. Hey, Sylvester, we hear that David Tennant's still going to do with a Scottish accent. What do you think of that? I thought, oh, God, what am I doing? I'm not here. And then I suddenly got this wheeze. I said, oh, well, he wants to prove to the world that Scots can do other accents. I mean, he can do Scottish standing on his head. Although, hopefully not while wearing a kilt. But anyway, he could easily do the Scottish accent. But therefore, it was a challenge for him to do an estuary accent, because it was very kind of estuary English. And so that was brilliant of him. But also, he wanted to prove to the world that Scots could. Because one of our greatest exports is Sean Connery. And, I mean... I mean, Sean Connery, when he was a Russian, he said, oh, yes, I am a Russian. And then when he was in the Highlander, he said, oh, yes, I'm an Egyptian. And then when he was playing an Irishman in The Untouchables, oh, yes, I am Irish. And they gave him an Oscar for that. And so I think that's why David did it. Just the root of the world, you know, the Scots can actually do other accents.
Good choice. We put our hands together.